Tonight on the Money Programme, I'm on my way to the launch of one of the world's biggest products. It'll generate billions in sales, and pretty soon, most of us will be using it.
Welcome to the Microsoft launch!
All this razzmatazz is for Microsoft's much-delayed operating system, Windows Vista. It cost a whopping $10 billion to develop, and it's vital to the future success of their business.
Bill Gates, the company founder, and also the world's richest man, has come to London to do the honours and do the launch.
How are you?
Nice to meet you. Sorry about the traffic.
Yeah, no problem.
In the first of a two-part series on how new computer technology is revolutionising our lives, we've got behind-the-scenes access at Microsoft.
Wow.
We'll reveal why this launch has taken years, also the crucial marketing and development decisions, and what Vista will look like when it's on your computer.
It's May 2006, and at Microsoft's UK headquarters near Reading, they're counting down to their biggest product launch yet. We're going to follow the process inside this massive and normally secretive organisation.
So the question is, time is short. It'd be really useful to know, kind of from each of you, what are the top one to three things that everyone's focusing on.
From a PR point of view, we've got the plans coming together now. They'll be briefed later on.
Top priority right now is getting the retailers up to speed on what Vista Capable is all about.
And then obviously the last one I want to work about is actually what we're going to do around launch event.
Cynthia Crossley has been in charge of Microsoft's Windows business in the UK for 3 years, but she's never run anything as big as this.
Windows Vista is a career-making moment for me. To launch Windows Vista means you are launching one of the most significant products in software history.
And this is what they have to sell. It's Microsoft's latest operating system, what makes your computer and all the applications on it work. But Vista also does a lot more. As this company promo shows, it lets different devices work together. Cynthia's team has to explain all that.
We've got potentially a lot of complicated messages. How do we make it simple and relevant for Joe Blogs in the street?
Microsoft's marketing wants to persuade us that Vista will make us more efficient, happier even. Cynthia wants to sell us the Vista lifestyle.
It's my team that basically tries to galvanize the UK industry so that people are not only aware of Windows Vista, but they're prompted to really understand the relevance to their lives, whether it's at home, work, on the go.
In a few short months, Cynthia has to get Vista into the shops, set up a marketing campaign, and arrange a big launch event.
So thanks, everybody. I'll be right back.
So what's the product behind all of this hype?
This is what Vista looks like. If you've used one of the previous versions of Windows, you will recognize it. But there are plenty of new features as well. You should be able to find things more easily through this search box. All the graphics have improved, so you can do fancy stuff, like this, with all the windows you have open. And they've even thought of helping parents control computer use by the use of this scheduler, to stop children logging on except when they're allowed to. Although I'm sure most kids will find a way around that in about 5 minutes flat.
By last spring, the developers had been working away on Vista for over 4 years. Eventually, the first prototypes were circulated inside the company to great excitement. In Microsoft, enthusiasm is a way of life.
This looks really cool.
Yeah, that would be cool.
Isn't that cool?
Cool.
That's pretty cool.
Cool.
My Money Programme colleague, Libby Potter, got a preview of Vista from Microsoft's chief executive himself, Steve Ballmer.
When Microsoft give you permission to actually meet him, they send out a kind of a blurb describing him, how they would like you to think of him. They say he's variously described as ebullient, focused, funny, passionate, sincere, hard-charging, and dynamic. Crikey.
Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Ballmer!
This clip of the hard-charging Ballmer has been a favourite on video-sharing websites for years. Scary stuff. Ballmer had just flown into London to set up the Vista launch, and luckily for Libby, he's not quite like that when he's got jet lag.
So let me give you just a little bit of a view. This is the basic desktop. Just look at how rich and exciting and good-looking that picture is. Just see how you flip through right now. You flip through the various applications that are running, new chess game built in. It's just amazing.
What is this launch going to be like?
This will be the biggest launch Microsoft's done absolutely since 1995, for sure, when we launched Windows 95 and Office 95. But the product is actually, the Windows Vista product and the Office 2007 product are more chock full of innovation, frankly, even than what we had in Windows 95. Now, you know, who knows how the world will react, but we're going to be out there as they say in the sales and marketing game, we're going to be out there bumping and thumping, telling the story of Windows Vista.
So how much do you know about all the sort of technology that runs behind this?
I know as much as a guy can know who's a CEO who didn't write any of the code.
Vista's the latest chapter in the spectacular story of Bill Gates, the Harvard dropout who started a software company 30 years ago. He believed that in the new computer business, software would be where the money was. The first version of Windows was built to run on almost all types of computer, making Microsoft a power across the industry. Gates was intensely involved in software development, personally conducting what were known as bill reviews with his teams of programmers.
The key members of a team would be in the room. You would make presentations to Bill, and you lived in fear of the... Bill has a tendency to say things like, "That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard," or to ask you very, very hard questions. Bill could smell fear. He knew if you were trying to bluff him. You kind of breathed a sigh of relief when your turn was over and you hadn't been damaged too badly.
When Bill needed help with management at Microsoft, he turned to his old college buddy, Steve Ballmer.
I can remember when Bill called me, absolutely, about coming to Microsoft. It was 1980. I remember it very well. I remember the discussion very well. I remember thinking it was highly unlikely that I would do so. And after I'd been at Microsoft about a month and a half, I was afraid. I had dropped out of school to be the bookkeeper of a small company, which didn't feel very good.
In fact, Ballmer had hit the jackpot. Microsoft went from strength to strength. When Windows 95 came out with a Rolling Stones soundtrack, Gates' extravagant ambition to put a computer on every desk and in every home started to become a reality. Microsoft shares went up for almost 15 straight years. Ballmer admits it wasn't what he'd expected.
I never would have anticipated we'd have a company of, you know, 40-plus billion in revenue and 70,000-plus people.
6 years ago, Gates made Ballmer chief executive. He also became, according to a recent list, the 15th richest man in America. Gates himself, worth $53 billion, was the richest in the world.
It was a partnership of opposites, the introvert and the extrovert, the programmer and the salesman. But it worked. Until this year, when, with a date for the Vista launch still not set, Gates and Ballmer called a surprise press conference.
After careful consideration, Steve and I decided to announce a 2-year transition plan that will shift my day-to-day responsibilities.
Gates was stepping down, but would stay on as part-time chairman of Microsoft. He wanted to spend his time, and most of his money, on the charity he runs with his wife, Melinda. Ballmer would continue as chief executive, but he'd take on Gates' responsibility for Microsoft's technology.
Obviously, Bill is a unique individual. You don't just say, okay, who's on the list to replace Bill Gates? But I have to really pick up the responsibility for being the champion of innovation. I'm not going to try to say I replace Bill Gates as our visionary. I don't.
Ballmer will have to adapt to his new role at a time when Microsoft is facing fierce competition from younger rivals like Google. All the more important, then, to get Vista out. But as 2006 dragged on, they were still struggling to complete it. For those at the coalface, it was an epic job.
The beginning of this video sort of reflects on our history and our past. We put a PC on every desktop, almost. We've done so much to date with the operating system.
Jenny Lam runs the visual design team for Vista. She sees it as a big responsibility.
Some knowledge workers, like myself, sit in front of a computer 5 days a week, you know, 6 to 8 hours a day. Some people don't spend that even that much time with the loved ones. So it's a pretty important experience to get right.
Here's what looks like becoming the most famous Vista icon, the new start button. Jenny and her team agonized over its every detail.
It's the one element that is pervasive throughout your experience. It's on top, and although it's little and in the corner, it's a fundamental part of sort of the face of Windows.
In previous versions of Windows, the start button has always included the word start.
This button is from Windows 95, and then this is the Windows XP start button.
And for years, clever dicks have enjoyed pointing out an anomaly.
You needed to click on start to shut down, and that seemed like a weird, not very intuitive thing to do.
Solution: lose the word start altogether.
Getting rid of start actually solves that problem, so that's kind of a nice thing now that we're a little proud of.
And rightly so. While the software was being built, it was also being tried out on computer users. Cheered Hoke set up a testing lab.
If you want to design something like Windows, you can't just start from scratch and wipe everything clean.
He soon found that most people are reluctant to alter their computer habits.
Well, if they've never seen it before, I can predict that they'll say, I'd rather have no change. And that's a natural tendency. People love what they're very comfortable with.
They show you what it's going to look like instead of just having the words for the options. This is all.
When they started testing early, more ambitious versions of Vista, they soon found it didn't take much change to make many people irritated and insecure.
It looks too weird.
It turned out that we were trying to get people to a place where they weren't yet prepared to go, given all their, you know, current habits and the things they've learned and what they know leads to success.
Like, I don't want to use that one.
So that's an area where we really have to make massive changes.
Oh, wow. That's really cool.
The features you'll see on Vista are the ones which Cheered found were popular and could be easily learned.
That's really slick.
Each new version of Windows gets more complicated as the programmers add more and more features.
It's a little bit like creating a snowball if you're making a snowman. You know, you roll the snowball around the garden and it gets bigger. We see that with Windows. Windows XP was 40 million lines of code. Windows Vista is 50 million lines of code. It's the scale of the complexity of the product. Clearly, that trend cannot continue forever.
That complexity was delaying Vista. By the summer of 2006, the developers had also been held up by having to fix security problems with the previous version of Windows, XP. Microsoft had wanted to get Vista out for Christmas, but that was looking doubtful. Even without a launch date, on the other side of the campus, the marketing team are at work. It's Mike Sievert's job to sell Vista to the world. And he's going to base the campaign on something he's noticed.
The first time somebody sees and experiences this operating system, they look at it and they say, wow.
The wow starts now.
Wow.
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 Mike's decided to use wow as the big idea in marketing Vista.
You know, let's make wow front and center in a way more than we had done before.
But they still have to decide what the ad should look like.
So what are we looking at here? I mean, obviously the visual approach is different from the last time we saw this.
Mike wants to get some extra wow into the drafts he's being shown.
Is there a way to bring more of that color back into the advertising? The earlier versions had it, and we've landed with these shades of gray.
Yeah, we talked about that last week, actually, with the brand team, because right now you see across the board kind of a current gray background, which is standard for the sake of not wanting to tinker. But is there a way we can add some sort of hue?
I do think it's all got to kind of weave together. I'm glad we'll have executions that show the whole desktop. I think that's important, so people can, you know, see a piece of advertising and they can see, you know, how different Windows Vista looks.
back in the UK and Cynthia has to set up her own British marketing campaign based on the big idea coming from the States. The Brits have quickly got the hang of it.
It's very much about the wow.
We want the wow, and they want the wow back.
Reignite that sense of wow.
It's a really big wow.
Wow being W-O-W.
Cynthia's job is to get millions of British consumers to try Vista and go wow. She's asked outside companies to come up with proposals. Simon Mahoney runs a marketing agency in Tunbridge Wells.
The brief is very specific. Get people to view a demonstration of Vista. When they do that, they go wow anyway because of the product.
Simon's idea is to run a big prize competition in shops and online.
By ensuring every customer watches a 2-minute demo of each key area. This will be done by offering the chance to win a sector-relevant wow, money can't buy prize. Now, it really does have to be...
The reward for being shown what Vista can do with photography, for instance, is the chance to win a safari.
Because what we want them to do is when they look at it, they need to go, and they will. Wow.
Cynthia was impressed.
We have been brainstorming, it feels like, for the last 20 years on what would be the big idea going up to launch in the UK. And I think this one is really powerful. It's very strong.
Simon, thank you very much indeed. It's good to meet you.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you. You're welcome. Cheers.
Now Simon has to deliver the wow he's promised, and he's only got a few months. Meanwhile, Cynthia has chosen the British Library for her UK launch event. She wants to put on a show demonstrating Vista to 250 journalists. Microsoft has been working with the British Library, developing software to let people view its archive online or here in the library foyer.
The British Library has developed an amazing application. It actually fits our idea around a wow concept in Windows Vista because it is so unique.
Microsoft has finally had to admit that Vista won't be ready before the end of 2006.
There's no doubt that the company selling PCs would have liked Vista to be loaded on their products and available for them to sell to customers before Christmas. The most important period for the PC industry as a whole. In most developed markets, it's typically 40% of the annual sale, is the fourth calendar quarter. And that's driven by those holiday season pre-Christmas sales.
We had originally slated that Windows Vista would be out before the holiday. Now it's out in January. And so, you know, that's a missed opportunity for us. At the same time, quality is what's most important in this development project. We're going to make sure that this is the highest quality release that we've ever done. And if that means a few weeks and means missing the opportunity of holiday, then that's the decision that we took.
Cynthia has invited Britain's most important retailers and computer manufacturers to Microsoft to tell them about Vista. These are the businesses most of us will buy Vista from, so they're the key to its success. And this crowd are not happy with the continuing uncertainty around the launch.
We need to know the date. That's very important.
Very important thing for retailers, some clarity around when things are going to actually happen.
Question is, can I remember?
Cynthia's determined to win them over with a traditional Microsoft product demo.
There's a history that comes with being at Microsoft and it comes with Windows, which is you put on a show making things really fun and exciting, but actually, I mean, these guys are running businesses. They need to know how to make money with us. Welcome. I'm just absolutely excited about today.
Windows Vista is great and it's just getting better.
I'm going to get taken, but here we go.
You've got to leave here today understanding what the opportunity is for you.
Because that is what will sell Vista.
It's magic.
The show seems to have done the trick.
It's incredible, absolutely incredible. And it's such a powerful tool when you think of how you can actually use that kind of technology in your everyday life.
I think Windows Vista is a very, very exciting new product launch.
Yeah, I was very impressed with the whole team. I'm just waiting to see them cook on the barbecue a bit later on.
But it would be a while before there'd be any more news about the launch date. Finally, in November, Microsoft announces that Vista will be in the shops on January the 30th.
Good afternoon, SNP.
Down in Tunbridge Wells, in the run-up to Christmas, the finishing touches are being put to the WOW competition. Simon Mahoney and his team are battling against WOW fatigue.
I think I must say it maybe 300 or 400 times a day. It must never lose its kudos, but that was a really tall order for us to deliver WOW. So when a consumer sees something, they click through, they go WOW.
Today, Microsoft marketing supremo Alistair Frost has come to approve the campaign idea. Simon wants to entice people to try Vista with this design.
What will happen when that goes live online, it will actually twist and become a vortex, which is extremely compelling.
Kind of starts to warp around, draws you through.
Clever.
And yeah. Now you're being sucked into the vortex that we've created.
Mm. I don't think anyone will be in any doubt about what it's all about. It's definitely got the WOW.
Oh, it's got the WOW factor too.
There's no question.
There's definitely a WOW there, isn't there?
It's certainly punching between the eyes. Nice.
Now all they have to do is to pick the right animal to promote the Safari Prize in the WOW competition.
Rhino, elephant.
Maybe not.
They're grey.
Lion, elephant. You see, that would work.
So can we put the lion?
The whole thing has been pretty tight. We'll certainly manage it, but it will be a busy Christmas for us all here, that's for sure.
Christmas, and just over 4 weeks till the Vista launch.
We are incredibly excited about this.
Thank you for your interest and your excitement.
Really excited.
It's the ultimate WOW.
It's the new year, and Cynthia's back at the British Library to sort out the final details. The launch event has taken on a new importance because they've got an unexpected VIP.
Well, we have Bill coming. So Bill Gates has agreed to come to our event in the UK, which we're quite excited about. In fact, we're incredibly excited about. And it's great, but it has added a whole new level of expectation and complexity.
So Bill will arrive from helicopter. We'll get him in here.
Right.
We'll get him straight into the speaker room, prep him, get him ready to go on stage.
So you'll be in the car with him, mm-hmm. coming in to brief him, and then we'll brief him here when he gets here. We've got about 15 minutes.
The pressure before is at a scale of 6, and it's now off the Richter at about 11.5.
Vista is finally rolling off the production line. It comes in 4 versions, costing from £99 up to £250. For some, a rather steep price, especially as you can buy Vista for about half that in the States. The advertising and marketing campaigns are unleashed worldwide. You can already guess what that means.
Wow.
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 Wow. Introducing Windows Vista.
January the 30th, and Vista launch events are held around the world. From the Great Wall of China to the Taj Mahal. From Rio to Times Square. The UK kicks off with this bizarre event in London.
The new operating system, Windows Vista! Today.
Simon Mahoney's WOW campaign soon attracts a crowd in Covent Garden.
Well, we got there in the end. We've got a huge ice sculpture, as you can see, that says WOW, with a 2.5-ton block of ice, which is something like 8 foot tall. And we're asking all the public to come along to celebrate the Windows Vista launch.
Across town at the press launch at the British Library, an audience of journalists is waiting for the show to start. But there's no sign of the star attraction, Bill Gates. Bill is stuck in traffic on the M1. We've waited, 6 years for Vista, so I suppose another 10 minutes won't matter that much. Finally, an unassuming people carrier draws up, and he's among us. The $50 billion man looks just like any other tired businessman straight off a transatlantic flight. Cynthia's career hangs on this going smoothly.
Hello, nice to meet you. Sorry about the traffic.
Yeah, no problem.
And just 4 minutes after arriving, Bill is on stage.
Well, good morning. This is a special occasion. In Windows Vista, we have the foundation to take things to a whole new level. We're unleashing people's creativity and excited about what can happen.
These journalists are used to the hype of a Windows launch. For many of them, Microsoft just isn't as cool as some of its new internet competitors like Google. But Bill Gates says he's confident he'll see off his rivals.
It is a very competitive environment. That's why we love it. You've always got to obsolete your old products. You've got to make something that's dramatically better. We have a range of competitors doing good things, including Google and search. And the direction of combining the power of your local PC together with great services in the internet, that's a direction we believe in very much.
Others say in the future, regular Windows updates will be downloaded over the internet, and that the big bang of a Vista launch may never be seen again.
Microsoft can no longer carry on developing ever bigger operating system products for personal computers. Therefore, we think that actually Vista will be the end of the road for big versions of the Windows operating systems on PCs, and as such, represents a crossroads for Microsoft.
But Microsoft is already working on a new role for Windows. It'll be the vital link between our different technology devices, as the company's future leader told us.
When people watch the BBC Money program in the future, they'll be sitting there and they'll yell out to one of their friends who's not in the room, "Hey, Harry, did you hear what Ballmer had to say about that?" And the TV will wake up and figure out who Harry is, and Harry will be sitting in his living room watching the BBC Money program, and he'll hear his buddy say, "Hey, did you hear Ballmer say that?" And that kind of experience will be the wave of the future.
The launch is over. Bill Gates is shown back to his car. For Cynthia, it's job done.
Are you relieved it's all over?
It's a bit of a catch-22 because you're right, you build up to a moment and it's nice to see it come to fruition. But, you know, this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity and it's going to be almost a shame just to see it end. Although good night's sleep would be good as well.
Across the country, shops are already full of new computers running Vista and Vista upgrade packs. So now it's the moment of truth. Will people buy it?
I think it's a good update, but I wouldn't buy it.
Oh, why not?
It's £150.
What about the price? Would you pay the money to upgrade?
If I get a new computer, yes. I'd upgrade right now, not really. It's a bit too expensive for me right now.
To me, the features that it comes with are not different from XP. Yeah. Sorry, Bill Gates, but it's true.
But Microsoft doesn't need to worry too much if people are put off by the cost of an upgrade. Vista will be pre-installed on almost all new computers, so they'll get the big sales anyway. That's the genius of Bill Gates's Windows business. Oh, and there was one thing about Vista that really impressed this lot.
We spoke to Bill Gates this morning, and he spent $10 billion on making that.
And that's a bit... Wow.
If you want to see more on this, go to bbc.co.uk/moneyprogramme. Next week, in the second part of Coming to Your Screen, Can Anyone Be a TV Star? We investigate the rise and rise of DIY TV.
And that's at the same time, 7 o'clock here on BBC2.